Hi, I'm Steve Johnson, Farm and Ag Business Management Specialist, Iowa State University Extension and Outreach. Let's take a look at crop marketing strategies. What we'd like to feature today is a crop marketing matrix. The matrix is dependent upon your view of futures prices. So the expected change in futures or the expected change in basis, will futures go up or down? Will basis weaken or strengthen? Depending on your expected change, pick the marketing tool that best fits. Is the marketing tool to take advantage of futures prices that will later increase, but that basis will weaken? Contracts such as a basis contract sell cash bushels and buy futures, or sell cash bushels and buy a call option, or perhaps a minimum price contract through an elevator, a co-op, or another grain merchandiser would be an opportunity to take advantage with an expected change of higher futures and a weaker basis. If you think futures prices are going to decline and the basis will weaken, make a cash sale now or a forward contract. If you think the futures prices will decline but the basis strengthen, we can use tools such as a hedge or a non-roll hedge to arrive, or buy a put option. In other words, we're locking in the futures price, but not necessarily the cash price or the basis. And if you think that we're going to see a futures price increase, but a strengthening basis, perhaps you store and wait, or a delayed price contract, or a minimum price contract. Your crop marketing strategies are combined with your understanding of marketing tools and the importance of having a crop marketing plan. I'm Steve Johnson, Farm and Ag Business Management Specialist, Iowa State University Extension and Outreach.